that I made a difference, that I made a difference for Africa and the developing world. You know, when I travel, individuals come up to me in the poorest nations on earth and they say, what has America done? Now, the reason is that everyone expects America to take an effort to make a difference in the world, because we are the most powerful nation in the world, but we also need to regain our moral authority. At the end of my administration, I hope to have achieved the concrete goal of ending genocide in Darfur, doing something about the humanitarian tragedy in that country, doing something about stopping the killings and the rapes, making a difference in bringing some kind of a peaceful settlement to a country that has had over 2 million displacements. I also want to make a difference in the areas of pandemic diseases, AIDS, refugees, malnutrition, enormous challenges in Africa, the poorest continent on earth. Why is it that nobody cares about Africa? I always say that. Why did we let Rwanda happen? We should care about peacekeeping conflicts in Africa. We should care about the fact that close to 20% of the entire continent may be HIV positive. We should forge public-private partnerships to make Africa a priority in the world's foreign policy. I think it's also important that we recognize that America needs to lead. My Marshall Plan for the 21st century will double assistance, triple assistance, in fact, in many areas of human needs to the African continent. We also need to look at future political crises there. Why isn't anybody doing anything about the crisis in Zimbabwe, where a leader who is bent on keeping his power wants to keep it at all costs at the expense of his own people? So there are a lot of challenges, but for Bill Richardson, who spent a lot of time as UN ambassador on African issues, on the Congo, on the Sudan, on many others, Africa will be a major priority in my foreign policy and in our international assistance policy.